Hello and welcome to AzureWala YouTube channel. We are in part 80 of Microsoft Certified Associate series. So far we have completed 138 questions in previous videos. Today we are going to look into question number 139 and 140. Question 139. You have an Azure subscription that contains a storage account shown in the following table. We do have one storage account which is having Azure Active Directory authentication enabled, and storage account 2 which is also having the Azure Active Directory authentication enabled, and the contents of storage 1 account is a container or blob container. The content of storage 2 account is file share named share 1. You plan to use AzCopy to copy a blob from container 1 directly to share 1. You need to identify which authentication method to use when you use AzCopy. What should you identify for each account? We are given 4 options, and we'll check on the document site of Microsoft that which authentication options are available. So let's go to Microsoft site. We are in Microsoft documentation site and get started with AzCopy page. We can scroll down. Under the authorize AzCopy section, we can authorize the credentials by using Azure Active Directory or shared access signature token. So for the blob storage type account, we can authorize by Azure Active Directory and SAS, both are supported. And for file storage, SAS is only supported. Back to the question. Therefore, in the answer area, for storage 1, we cannot use OAuth, we cannot use anonymous, and we cannot use storage account access keys to authenticate. We have only one choice, which is the SAS one. Therefore, this option is the correct answer. And if we would have the option of Active Directory, we can use that one as well. For the storage account 2, which is the file share storage account, and we can only use SAS token authentication method for storage 2. Question 140. You have an Azure subscription named subscription 1 that contains the resources shown in the following table. We have resource group 1 and resource group 2. We do have one recovery service vault named vault 1. We do have 3 storage account, storage 1, storage 2 and storage 3. And we do have 3 log analytic workspace, so analytics 1, analytics 2 and analytics 3. You plan to configure Azure backup reports for vault 1. You are configuring diagnostic settings for the Azure backup reports log. Which storage accounts and which log analytics workspace can you use for the Azure backup reports of vault 1? So in the answer area, we need to select the storage account, which storage account we can use along with the vault 1, and which log analytics workspace can be used with the vault 1. To understand it better, let's go to Microsoft documentation portal. We are in Microsoft documentation site. It create and configure a recovery service vault page. If we scroll down, the vault must be in the same region as the data source. So vault and storage account should reside in the same region. Next, let's see log analytics workspace. We are in Microsoft documentation portal on configure Azure backup reports page, and we scroll down. We are at create a log analytics workspace or use an existing one. Here we can see the location and the subscription where this log analytics workspace can be created is independent of the location and subscription where your vault exists. Therefore, we can use any of the log analytics workspace from the option. Our recovery service vault is residing in West Europe region, and our storage 3 account is residing in West Europe region. Therefore, storage account 3 can be used along with the vault 1. Storage 3 only is the correct answer. Similarly, we know that log analytics workspace is independent of the location and subscription. Therefore, any of the log analytics workspace can be used along with vault 1. I hope this video was informative for you. Please hit the like button.